Well, in West Texas, of course, you got border radio. And you'd hear Ernest Tubb 1 minute and Muddy Waters the next song, you know, and then they'd play six or seven songs and you could buy this collection, you know. So all that, and Conjunto music, San Antonio, you know. There was a little black barbecue joint out on Stove Foundry Road. And I heard Honey Hush playing. Then I really did lose my mind. And the next time was at the Midnight Movie. Now this was a big deal back in the 50s, the Midnight Movie, because nothing went past 10 o'clock anywhere. Midnight Movie of Rock Around the Clock. And it was packed. And it starts off with that one, two, three, and everybody just went nuts. The thrill of that was I've never known anything like it. Before I met Bruce, I'd already had a band. Well, that was 62. And I had a band, first band we had was called the Mellow Fellas in 1957. And we had four guitar players, none of us could play. The drummer had a snare drum and a conga drum. That was it.
He had a band and was working all the time. And he'd back up all the blues artists that would come to town. Howlin' Wolf, you know, Jimmy Reed, anybody in the blues that would come. Well, Delbert plays harmonica and his band would back him up.
Well, I didn't teach him anything. He was already playing the harp. But I'll tell you how it goes. Of course, when Hey Baby was the number one song in England, he got booked over there 6 weeks. And the promoter says, we gotta have the harmonica player. You know, because, you know, I mean, hey. So, hence I get to go. This girl that had been following Bruce around, we were dead tired, and we were just standing in the dressing room. She said, you gotta come hear this band. They're the hottest group in the North, and they're just back from Europe. It's the Beatles. And they were amazing. Everybody wanted to know if you knew Elvis. Finally, I said, hell yeah, I used to loan him lunch money. You know? She's living it up, and I'm trying to live it down. You know, I write at home. I seldom ever write when I'm on the road. I don't know why, but I never have, you know. I'm in that mode, and that's... But I, every day, I expose myself. I get up in the morning, I have a cup of coffee, I either pick up a guitar or sit down at the piano and give it an hour, you know? And sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
The first time I met Delbert, he was practicing somewhere right off West Berry Street in Fort Worth at a, I guess you could call it a rehearsal hall. I mean, damn place barely had electricity. And he was struggling, but he was not giving up, no way, no how. And to us, and I'm talking, I'm 17 years old, 16, 17 years old, he was a legend. There was blues, there was country, there was rock, there was all these American music influences there that came out of the South. And he didn't see any problem with marrying him up. Don't want your money, honey, don't need your car. Doing all right so far. Giving it up for your love, everything. Giving it up for your love, right now. Giving it up for your love, honey, everything. Giving it up for your love somehow. I'm giving it up for your love.
They're completely different from me because, you know, live performance is a live performance and you get out of it what you put into it. And there's no going back and fixing anything. So that's very much just what it is. You gotta go out there and do the show and you gotta be good. But the best part about it is even a bad show, I've always couldn't wait to redeem myself. Well, everything I learned about music, I learned in Texas. And well, I'm from Texas. When you're from somewhere, this is, well, there's no place like Texas, but when you're from Texas, it's kind of like if you don't know, I can't tell you. And if you do know, I don't need to say anything.
The nightlife ain't a good life, but it's my life.
Nightlife is my favorite, I think, because the first time I ever heard it, it was exactly my life. Exactly. And it boiled down into whatever, 2.5 minutes.
The way she left sure turned my head around. Seemed like overnight she just up and put me down. Ain't gonna let it bother me today. I've been working and I'm too tired anyway. But it's alright, cause it's midnight and I got 2 old bottles of wine. I'm 1600 miles from the people I know.
Oh man, the only advice I can give somebody is don't leave your wallet in the dressing room while you're on stage.
Thought I'd be a big star by today.